a vlog.
Wow, we have gremlins in this house. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CC Films. It's a vlog. Yes, as you can see by the new perspective and the new camera angle, basically I have revamped my gaming room if you have checked out the video on my iPod channel. But if you already know about it on my iPod channel, then you already know that I changed the perspective of my gaming room due to the fact that basically I need to get my mates in and out, so it makes them get in and out because it's troubling because the different layout. The other layout that I had, it was had problems on people getting in and out, you see. So it's a new perspective, it's much easier for to get in and out, as you can see. I'm, you know, like, in and out, shake it all about. And basically, as you can see, that I'm wearing my shorts because, and plus my flip-flops because it is Sunday, and particularly, I don't particularly like Sundays because there's not much people online. And plus, it's a good time to do a vlog on a Sunday. So I'm going to have to keep you up to date on what's been happening. Now, I won't go through all the bullcrap that has been happening. I'm going to go to the good stuff now and do the bullcrapness and all that later. Right, the first stuff that I want to discuss about is loads of people have been querying about the new Medal of Honor because loads of people have been asking how is it and why did you buy it and stuff. Right. First of all, I did try out the beta for this, the multiplayer beta for it. And I really enjoyed the beta. It was like a fast-paced version of Battlefield Bad Company 2. And basically, I quite enjoyed it, and I basically picked up mainly for the multiplayer. But in case people are interested in the campaign, it's quite good, the campaign is. It's just that it has a really different engine because there's two developers, two different types of engines developing on this game. Because the DICE Frostbite engine for the multiplayer is the best part that I just love for some reason. And the other engine for the single player campaign is a bit but the campaign's quite good. I played it. It was okay-ish, but I mainly bought this mainly because of the multiplayer. Now, I know people have been saying, like, oh, Steven, you're wasting your money again and stuff like that, but I don't know. I just wanted to pick it up and plus stuff like that. And there was, Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 2 that recently came out the same day as this came out. But I might pick it up on a later date when it's, like, cheaper or something. But at the meantime, I've got other stuff on my plate, like Medal of Honor and Fallout New Vegas. I'll have a game next week, and the week after that will be Fable 3. Now, speaking about Fable 3, another loads of stuff have been happening about Fable this week, which I want to discuss about. Mainly, the Kingmaker that I was surprisingly lucky enough to get working on the iPod Touch. Here it is, on the iPod Touch. This is the 4G model, by the way. I'm not so sure if it'll work on your 2G or 3G models, but it actually does work, so I plant a flag. It's planting, there you go, and I planted a flag and it works quite well. It works by Wi-Fi hotspots, and it's quite funny because I went to my local McDonald's, I had Wi-Fi, and basically I planted a flag on my Wi-Fi on in McDonald's, and it's really cool. So basically I can actually get gold now for Fable 3 that will be coming out soon. So I'm really pleased that it works on my iPod Touch 4G model. Like I said before, I'm not so sure on the 2G model or the 3G model, you see, because I only got a 4G model and stuff like that, which is cool. Right, another thing that I'm going to discuss about, another thing that's Fable related, is recently on Xbox Live that basically Fable 2, the full game, which is this game, a fantastic game, is doing a free online games on demand thing where it's completely free, honestly completely free. Now, I bet you're wondering, why is Microsoft and plus Lionhead Studios are making this game for free? Well, due to the fact that it gets more popularity for Microsoft, for people to go on their Xboxes and download this free, full, fantastic game. Plus, not only that, Peter Molyneux, the head of Lionhead Studios, did say that did say in an article one time that I read ages, months ago, that Peter Molyneux did say that he wanted loads of sales for Fable 3, you see. Because he wants millions from the sales of Fable 3 when it comes out. So this is why he's basically doing Fable 2 for free. Now, as you, if I show you on my netbook, just quite show you for real, is basically for free, as you can see. I'll give you a close up. I don't know if you can't see it, but basically, yeah, it's kind of free. Here's the full game. I have tried it out. I have downloaded the 7 GB download, because it was 7 GB to download, and it was actually a full free game. Most people said it was an episode. I'm not so sure about that. I know there is the free episode version and stuff like that, but basically the majority of that is, it is a full free game. I have tested it on my hard drive without the Fable 2 disc, and explain why I downloaded it. I downloaded it because I wanted to try it out, and it does work on my DLC that I have, plus my save data that I have on that, and it works completely well. Plus, it runs a bit smoother. Now, I bet you're wondering, Stephen, why did you download it on your hard drive? It's a waste of space. Due to the fact I do have a copy of Fable 2, it's because it is getting a bit beat up, the disc, because I had it for like a couple of years now. And this load time seems to be not loading as quite well as it used to nowadays, because the disc is a bit beat up. But it's good to have it on the hard drive, so I can, like, say for example, if I go to my mum's one time, and if I wanted to have a quick play on Fable 2, then I could play on Fable 2. And it just loads really a bit quicker because it's all on the hard drive, not on disk space and stuff like that. So, loads of Fable stuff that have been happening this week. Yeah, now we're going to move on to the bullcrap that has been happening. Well, not actually bullcrap, it's just for me though that I've been having loads of issues on YouTube, and loads of stuff been happening this week that I don't want to mention because I don't want to upset any people, because I have, don't know, upsetted people, and I tried apologising and stuff. It's just loads of YouTube drama that has been happening this week, haven't it? It's just, yeah, and all that. It's just, you know, I just don't know how to communicate because of my disabilities, because I don't know their body language, what people are going through. You see, after the mishaps of what I've been doing on YouTube, and plus the absence on Xbox Live because of can't use party chat because of my Xbox 360 using the beta at the moment, and I can't be able to use party chat, so because of my absence, and plus doing lame stuff, and this kind of lame stuff that I did on YouTube is affecting everyone, you see, because of my absence and plus stuff that I did on YouTube. But anyways, speaking about YouTube, I have been doing loads of content this week. Well, free content to be exact. I did the Force Unleashed 2 demo gameplay, the Sonic 4 XBLA gameplay, and also the opening for Medal of Honor. Now, I'm not being ego, well, I can be a bit ego sometimes. It's just for some reason, because of all this YouTube drama and all that, it's not getting much as I expected because of you know, because all the stuff that has been happening to me on YouTube lately, and I'm not getting much respect on my YouTube page due to the fact that basically it's not getting it as it used to be. Because when I used to do demo gameplay, sometimes it gets as much as it can for when I do them. It's just weird though that I think maybe because some people have errors on their subscription boxes, and maybe because they can't see my videos on their subscription boxes, maybe because they subscribed to too many people and they didn't see my videos quite well, and other types of stuff. I'm trying to figure out why that basically not much people. I know loads of people have been having these problems on YouTube for the past couple of months. You see that not much people are not getting much people watching their videos, and because you have a low subscribers and all that. I know I'm trying to do this as positive as possible, because I don't want to go too eager, because it is just boggles me all the time with this issue and stuff like that. But yeah, and speaking about videos, that I might be quitting gameplays, because I'm not so sure, because if this is going to be a moral point that gameplays are getting out of date these days, and the whole point of Stevie T films without the films is that, you know, because I haven't done any films for quite a while, you see, and I would like to get back into my parodies and my films and all, and start maybe go on a hiatus on my gameplays, you see, because, you know, it's just weird though that basically the whole YouTube scenario just boggles me a bit. I might go on a hiatus. Not on a hiatus on YouTube, I mean like a hiatus on gameplays, because due to the fact that, well, to be honest, there are not much gameplays at the moment, even though it's coming to the fall season now, and it's nearly almost Christmas, and due to the fact that there's not much shown gameplays to do, I might as well go on a hiatus and start working on my films and parodies, and maybe some tutorials on achievements and whatnot. But overall, I am fine and dandy. It's just all this bullcrap is starting to affect me, and I don't understand people's body language due to that of my Asperger's syndrome. I'm not really good with socialising because of my Asperger's syndrome, you see. Which boggles me a bit. It's just yeah. But anyways, enough about the glum face, the unhappy face. Let's turn that frown upside down and talk about a couple of things. All right. Videos. Now, I'm not so sure what videos I might do. I might do a tutorial on a certain achievement on Sonic 4. Because there is an achievement where you had to basically get 99 lives. And I found out a way to get 99 lives a bit quicker. In case many of you already played Sonic 4 or you know about it. But I might do a tutorial in case you guys are that interested. And speaking about Sonic 4, loads of people have been complaining about the price of it, because loads of people have been complaining about the price of my gameplay due to the fact it is like £10 or 1,200 Microsoft points for a full graphical 2D game, and plus it only has a few levels and a few boss battles. Which I do understand. It's because, you know, Sega is trying to get more money because of the hard work that they tried to make the Sonic games a bit more better. I'm not dissing you Sonic fans out there, in case any Sonic fans are a bit offended. It's just, you know, Sega trying their very best to get their respect back for Sonic games, you see. It's like me, though. Like, I'm trying my best to gain my respect back and not do many of these stupid YouTube videos and start working on my YouTube's a bit better so I can get more respect back. It's like Sega is having the issue that I'm having at the moment. But Sonic 4 is a fantastic game. If you do have the Microsoft points, then do get it and stuff like that. Speaking about Microsoft points, I'm still doing the deal, which is the spend 2,400 Microsoft points and you get 800 Microsoft points for free. And basically, I will be getting the Battlefield Bad Company 2 DLC that I mentioned on my opening video of Medal of Honor. That basically, I will be picking up the DLC for it, because there are two DLCs that I wanted that I mentioned on the last vlog. But I will be picking them DLCs up, and it will give me more Microsoft points boost, so I can claim my 800 Microsoft points for free, which I'm looking forward to. And it might come out in a couple of months, because of sometimes their Microsoft deals take a while to prompt you and put it into your account, because they did say in the description below it takes till November 30th for everyone to have 800 Microsoft points for free. It says in the small print on the details on the offer. Anyway, sorry, I'm burping. Anyway, so I'm gonna quit with my jibber jabber, and I said my words and stuff like that. So in case you guys haven't followed me on Twitter and Facebook, this is why you should follow me on Twitter and Facebook. That way you already might know about the whole situation with the whole free download for Fable 2. It is a really good download. It's still available for free. I know most people have been having issues with it, and I don't know what the issue is, maybe because you're in different regions or anything like that. Because I know some people in Canada at the moment are having problems downloading this. But yeah, so in case you guys have any problems with it, I'm not so sure about the problem. But I have downloaded it for free. It's quite good to have a free downloadable game, full retail game. And yeah, so that is my update. Guys, do not forget to check out my Facebook and Twitter so you know more information about how I got it and stuff like that, my reaction to how I got the Fable 2 game. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steedy Films.